Hello. Sanbonang dumelang, hello. Right. Okay, let's try to keep it down so I can deliver my 2-minute speech, then I can go back to work. My name is David Tlale. Before I say whatever I say, we all have phones, right? Yeah. We're all on Instagram, right? Yeah. Who's following us on Instagram? Who's following us on the Intern SA? Do you know about the Intern SA? Yeah. Are you following us on Instagram? Yeah. Are you sure? Yeah. Okay, but if you're not following us, I want you to take your phone and go to your Instagram and follow us, the Intern SA, right now. It's free. Auna data. Taurekela data next week. Okay. Let's try to keep it simple, guys. I have a lot to talk about, and I also want to give you an opportunity. You can ask me questions. My name is David Tlale. I'm born in Vosloorus, Kobasotong. I was raised by a single parent. I went to the Tomo Primary School. I finished my high school, go to Dolisedi, and I studied accounting. And in 1993, I went to study internal auditing, which I hated with a passion. And in 1994, I went to study fashion design at Vali University in Vanderbijl Park. I studied for 4 years. I've been a best student in fashion for 3 years, from my second, third, and my fourth year, because I know one thing for sure: there is power in making a decision and taking hold of your future and also your destiny. Many of us say, oh, I grew up in a township. There's nothing wrong being raised in a township. There's everything right with being raised in a township. Because I'm a pure and proud product of Bantu education, and I know what is oppression, I know what is democracy, and I know what is making a decision in life. Today I'm standing here proud to be a South African, born in South Africa, made in South Africa, trade in South Africa, and also becoming a patriot of South Africa. I wouldn't be who I am today if I was raised in America or in Europe or anywhere else in the world, because my tradition, my heritage, my background, the me playing in the street, the ghetto, the bege, bati, mkusha, made this that you see today. Some of you don't know what I'm talking about. It's okay, you're born free, it's all good. I'm not judging you, I'm just saying this is who I am. And as I was growing up as a young person, I was a scout boy. I started as a cub and a scout boy, and I became a rover. And then from there, I was a Sunday school teacher. I was a choir master at church. I was a youth leader at church. And I did quite a lot of things, and I made sure that I invest a lot in myself with my time. And guess where I'm at today? Wow. These moments when I talk to young people or even I give a speech, most of the time it's just time for me to reflect of where I come from. My mother was a domestic worker, and her being a domestic worker was nothing wrong with it. There was everything wrong with a decision that I would have made at that particular moment. When I finished my matric to say, am I going to go get a job or am I going to go and become educated? I made a decision to become educated because today I've curbed the chain of not being professional or not being a professional in a family, because this is how it runs. My great-grandmother was a domestic worker. My grandmother was a domestic worker. My mother was a domestic worker. And one of my sisters as well was a domestic worker. I had a choice to say, this is where it comes to an end. We are not going to have a family chain of domestic workers right through our journey. And I chose to become David Tlale, who's going to go to school. Meaning there is power in being educated, because that stops your history but starts your destiny. Because if you have a piece of paper in your hand, you're able to knock at anyone's door or at any company to say, this is who I am, I have this, can you please employ me if you're not an entrepreneur? And I decided I am not going to be working for anybody, but I'm going to be working for myself. And my journey begins when I was still at university. I decided I'm not going to be, in my first early days, I'm not going to be looking for jobs, but jobs are going to come and look for me. There is power in uttering your dream. There is power in writing it down. There is power in waking up to your dream every day. After I graduated on my fourth year, I was still at school, at home, just trying to find myself what I'm going to do. I get a call from Valley University. They say, come, we have a position for you to come and be a part-time lecturer. There's a lecturer that's gone to maternity leave. And then I took up the opportunity. I was meant to be there for 6 months. 4.5 years later, I was still lecturing, asking myself, when is this lady giving birth, because it's supposed to be maternity leave? And this is 2003, April, I remember very well, when I said, I'm done with being an academic because I have a bigger calling, which is my vision of becoming a brand. In 2003 in Delhi, I resigned. I handed in my resignation form to say, I'm done with lecturing, but I'm going to pursue my career. They said, but how are you going to do this? My mother was not very happy with me the second time around in my life. She was like, how are you going to survive? I'm like, don't worry, God will provide. And 2003, I quit. I started the brand David Tlale. And immediately after that, I entered the L New Talent at South African Fashion Week, won the competition. That's how I actually introduced the brand in the industry. And over the years, it's been snowballing. And 2005, I was headhunted by House of Monatic, which is a factory in Cape Town that is actually manufacturing suits, Carducci, C-Squared, you name it. They have quite a few brands. And I was head designer for Carducci Women for 2.5 years. And 2007, I was just done. I'm being distracted by a full-time salary, because when you are comfortable, you're not able to push yourself to the next level. I was like, I'm done of getting this salary, which I can make 10 times that on my own and become a greater person. And I left in 2007, and then I joined African Fashion International, where I showcased first time in a solo. And immediately after that, I was one of the four designers to get to showcase at Paris Fashion Week. And it was me, Tula Cindy, Tabani Mavundla, and Craig Jacobs. That journey for me, 2007, was very important because I changed the way I saw things. I changed the vision of my journey to say, I want to become a global brand. And indeed, 2007 was a defining moment. After that, I won so many competitions, so many accolades. Then I won Best Designer in Africa at African Fashion International to showcase at New York Fashion Week, working with the likes of Chanel Iman, Tyson Beckford, Lia Gebede, you name it. And at that moment, it was evident to me to say, it's okay to dream and to dream bigger than you can. Your budget or your pocket or your bank account cannot limit your dream. Dream bigger than what you have. Because if you believe in the God that I serve, I know that He will definitely provide. And in 2012, I started a program in KZN called The Intern by David Tlale, which I was running in-house. 2 years ago, met an angel sent by God. Ms. Fele Nyende, who is the CEO of FP&M Seta, that has made the intern by David Tlale a success over the years. We are currently running on SABC 3 every Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. If you didn't watch over the time, you can catch up on YouTube. It's there. And you can also catch it up on Saturday at 1 o'clock on SABC 3. The program, The Intern by David Tlale, is out there to find young designers who are hungry for a breakthrough in the industry. I'm going to call Ntando Ngwenya to come. I met Ntando almost over 2 years now. He interned with us for 18 months, and he ultimately won the ultimate prize of being my assistant designer. He's currently working with us in the business as my assistant designer, and there's other two designers that are still at work, Siposi Hlemasango and Cindy Mfabe, who are working in the business. They were part of the internship for 18 months, supported by the FP&M CETA, and today he's got himself a job with us on a full-time basis. Maybe I can give you a minute to say something.
Morning, guys. How are you? Good, good. It's good to see that a lot of youth is still in school today. Guys, my story is a bit different from, I think, a few people, but maybe it's not different from a lot of people that you know. I grew up in the township. I managed to take myself out of there. I managed to follow my dreams, and here I am today. I'm assistant designer to Mr. David, you know. Growing up from Soshanguve, you don't have much time or most opportunities that you would get when you're in town, when you're in Joburg. So basically from school, Tshwane South College, and then I just started working for myself. Working for yourself, you need to know how to be consistent. You need to know what you're doing. You need to understand what it is that you're doing. And again, when you come to town, you mustn't lose focus. Friends, all these party lifestyle, everything, it doesn't pay rent at the end of the day. So you must learn how to make ends meet properly. And when you work for someone as powerful as David, you need to know how to be accurate. You need to know how to be a perfectionist, so to say. And yeah, from there on, I mean, you just have to follow your dreams and keep doing what you love, you know? And yeah, I think that's about it. Believe in yourself.
So he won't tell you how hard I am at work, but it's fine. Based on the success of the internship that he was part of, I mean, when he came and with the other designers, they haven't showcased at Fashion Week. We trained the designers to build a cohesive collection, and they got an opportunity to showcase at Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week Joburg, Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week Cape Town. We took them to Lagos Design Week. They showcased at Windhoek Fashion Week. And today he's an assistant designer for David Tlale and has just joined the new program called Curate Africa, which is taking the postgraduates of the internship to the global market. So you can watch out for this face and much more designers to come out of this program. Thank you, Ntando. And now I'm going to show you the army that makes The Intern by David Tlale. Come, children. Yes, of course. Yes. Your daddy was blown away. He robbed that grocery store. Don't you know that was a sad, sad old day? All your young life you've seen such a misery and pain. World is a cruel place to live and it ain't gonna change. So this is the army of the intern by David Tlale. I'm sure you've seen them on TV every Wednesday. And I'm going to quickly give a quick profile. The girl with the cap and the glasses, her name is Ila. Right in the beginning there, we have Frank Ramatsetse. He's the Mr. Razzmatazz. He's from Limpopo. Ila is from the is from Gauteng. Then we have Denver, who's from Cape Town. We have Kyla, who's also from Cape Town. We have Micheline, who's from the Val, where I studied. We have Lulama, who's from KZN. Oh, Lulama, you've got fans. Then we have Sam, who is from KZN. Then we have Musa, who's from the East Rand. Oh, hey. Oh, hey. Then we have Buitumelo from Limpopo. Then we have Keletso Muraba from Limpopo. Okay, I'm sorry. Then we have Kwena Mushweshwe, all the way from Lesotho, but residing in South Africa. And we have Velemina from Limpopo. So these are the future of the fashion industry. And this program is proudly made possible by partnering with FP&M Seta. And it's not only about TV guys, it's all about skill transfer, making sure that the designers can build a cohesive collection that fits well, that is finished well. It's not about the frills and feathers, but it's all about the quality of clothing. As the intern by David Tlale, our mission is to make sure that we bring integrity in the clothing sector, we bring excellence, black excellence, and also white excellence, and South African excellence that can sell in South Africa internationally, and make sure that we show Marc Jacobs flames. And I think these people can do it, isn't it? So as you see us here, we are the intern. Just before I sit down, I just want to say to the CEO, thank you very much for the support that you're giving us. We are looking at doing more seasons and growing the industry. We really appreciate it with you, your team that is supporting Shares, who was fabulous yesterday on TV. Did you guys see Shares last night on TV? Yes. And other people from... I'm going to talk about the protectors for the CEO, Runga and Q, and also William Malema and everybody else from the office. You guys have been phenomenal. Thank you very much. You make us want to dream bigger and better. One more thing, as a young person in South Africa, don't go to school for nothing. Wake up every morning with purpose and go to bed with reflection, asking yourself, what am I doing with my life? What do I want to achieve? And how will I change my country? Thank you very much.